I'm Sam Howers here on the set of The Chosen in Texas, and I'm delighted to say that I am joined by Giovanni, who plays Thaddeus in The Chosen. Thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, thanks, Sam. Appreciate it. Looking forward to talking with you.
Season 3 is coming up. People are very excited.
Season 3 is coming.
What can you tell us about what happens?
Oh, boy. Well, we got some surprises coming for you in Season 3 of The Chosen. We're going to meet some new characters I think you guys are going to be really excited about. And the honeymoon's over. You know, the disciples are really going to feel and see what it is to follow Jesus. A lot of hard obstacles come, but I think you guys are going to be excited for what's to come as well.
Fantastic. What's the best thing and what's the most difficult thing about being an actor on The Chosen?
Oh, well, that's a good question. I think the best thing is the people we get to work with every day. These aren't just co-workers. This is a family. And that was very clear from season one. And we've just grown stronger. We have actually a WhatsApp group text that we all keep each other kind of posted on what we're doing, crack jokes with each other in between seasons, even when we're not working. So I truly just love these guys. So that's the best part. The worst part? I feel like Dallas is going to fire me if I say the worst part. I would say the tough part is the extreme weather conditions. We've done extreme cold last season and extreme heat this season.
Really?
But I feel like I'm numb to the fact of it now, so I've gotten used to
it. And why was that? Is that just because the weather here in Dallas is...
No, I think the thing is just when we film, like we did Feeding of the 5,000 this year, and we did, I think it was close to 100 degrees every single day, but it was record heat for when we were filming. And then for Sermon on the Mountain season 2, I didn't know Texas got to like 15-20 degrees, but it did. But yeah, those were the two extremes for sure.
Amazing. And one of the things the fans say about the show is, I heard one person say, it's great, I watch it with my family and my teenage daughter, she really loves the show, but it makes her fact check. It makes her go back to her Bible. And it's like, it's amazing, it's a TV show that makes my teenage daughter fact check, is this really in scripture? Is that something that you guys have done as actors at all, you know, when you think, okay, this is interesting, this is the writer's take on it. Does it make you go back to the Bible as well and think, is that exactly how it was written at the time?
Well, it's interesting. I definitely, when I'm researching or looking at different stories of the Bible from things we've already filmed, it makes me picture it in different ways and be like, oh, I didn't see it that way. Something with me personally, just being able to see something on screen, it makes it that much more clear to me. And I wasn't thinking about that before we started filming, but to see people watch The Chosen and be able to go back to their Bible or being able to go back to the stories that were told, and have a clearer picture and more of an understanding of it, I think that's absolutely incredible.
And is there a spiritual kind of atmosphere on set, if I can put it that way? Because on the one hand, you are an actor, you're making a TV show. On the other hand, as you know, there's a huge spiritual dynamic to the producers and to really what the show is all about. So how does that work for you on set? Is there a spiritual atmosphere?
Well, I think the main thing that a lot of my cast members would agree with is it's changed our lives in ways in terms of wanting to connect with people. And I think that's a big thing for me personally. I can speak on playing Thaddeus. He's a very hard on his sleeve peacemaker, wanting everyone to be on the same page. So what he has taught me, not only with communicating with my castmates, my family, my friends, people I'm just meeting for the first time, it's sharing that love and connection. And it's truly a family on set of The Chosen. You know, we love each other. We're a family, and that connection has just gotten stronger from each season. So
I suppose that's really important for the disciples, because if you have a strong connection with your fellow actors offset, it's going to translate on screen, isn't it?
Absolutely. And that translates like offset too. I mean, like we're hanging out, playing games on our off time, playing card games, video games. Noah, who plays Andrew on The Chosen, is a big gamer of Smash Brothers.
Okay.
And he beats a lot of the cast members doing that. So we have bonded over that. And it's great. We all keep in contact like during the off season too, and we'll get together for lunch and coffee when we're in the same town. So it's a special group on The Chosen.
we know that the desire is to reach a huge number of people with the show, and millions are already watching it, but the goal is 1 billion.
1 billion.
How much does that play into your thinking? Do you think about that a lot or not?
I personally don't, because I feel like it's going to keep spreading in the best possible way. It's been humbling to see how many people throughout the entire world are grasping onto it. Especially the younger generation, a story that really stands out for me is when we were doing the premieres of Christmas with The Chosen last November, got a chance to go back to my hometown theater where I grew up watching movies and talk to some family members and other families that were gathered to watch The Chosen. And I was done talking to one of these families, and their two boys had to be 6 or 7 years old, run up to me and wrap their arms around me, give me a hug, and see it in their eyes, and they're just saying, thank you so much. And that touched me emotionally, because I was never touched by this type of content when I was younger. I think the main message The Chosen's trying to spread is the humanity, the connection, the love, and to see it expressed through the eyes of the younger generation. I mean, you can't help but get emotional thinking about that. Yeah.
And it is unique in that sense, as you say, of there have been other portrayals of Jesus, of course, but there hasn't been a multi-series portrayal like this. And,
yeah.
And often the criticism has been that Jesus come across as very ethereal, very otherworldly,
sure.
Whereas this Jesus, of course, is very human, as you say.
Absolutely.
Why has it taken so long for there to be a multi-season portrayal of Jesus in a way that people can relate to?
That I don't know. I'm just blessed The Chosen has been able to do it. And Jonathan Rumi, who plays Jesus so wonderfully, and he's just a kind-hearted soul. He was meant to do this. And he shows that to all his castmates. But the way he portrays Jesus, that he's dancing with the disciples and his friends at the wedding of Cana in season one. He's cracking jokes and he's shedding tears, whether they be of joy or sadness, but he's expressing that emotion. And I think, like you said, that was something that I know for me growing up, I could never connect with Jesus in those emotional ways, but you're seeing that humanity, you're seeing that connection expressed through, and I think that's what people really want. I know I do. When I'm watching a movie, I want to relate to who I'm watching, and The Chosen's been able to do that beautifully.
One of the things The Chosen does so well is it brings in plausible backstory, storylines, nothing that contradicts scripture, but things that seem plausible, like, okay, kind of filling in the blanks. But that also creates talking points and even controversy sometimes, because people watch it and think, well, that's not quite in the Bible. Why have they done it that way? Is there anything in season three that you think will really get people talking and really debating the kind of issue of, oh, I never really thought of that before. Would Jesus or would the disciples have really done that?
Yeah, I think in The Chosen, a big theme of season three of The Chosen is there are many obstacles that will always come our way as hardships that come on unpredictable times. But together, you know, we can get through a lot. And that's really deep-rooted in our faith, in our strength, and our togetherness. So I think there's going to be a lot of moments, especially with feeding of the 5,000. I think you're going to see a lot of those moments. That's a big thing this year in season three. We had over 12,000 people from all 50 states, over 30 countries come there to share that scene with us, share that moment. And I think people are going to relate to that in a positive way.
What's the fan reaction like when people see you? What the sorts of things they say, the fans, about you and The Chosen?
They're very generous. I mean, our fans are the best in the world. I love those guys. You know, the one thing is they always say, like, thank you for this gift, but they're giving us this gift right back. You know, they're buying into this with us. They're on this journey with us, and it doesn't happen without them. So to them, I would just say thank you, and we've got more to come.
Do you think the way The Chosen has pioneered, really, a new model of doing TV, do you think it's going to catch on and others will start to fund TV in the way The Chosen has? It's not really been done before in the same way.
I mean, I certainly hope so. The fan support has been absolutely incredible. And I hope it does, because I think it gives so many stories the opportunity to be told in such a unique way, especially when it comes to the relatability factor. And I think it's giving those projects that may not have had that opportunity this chance. So I'm glad The Chosen has been kind of that, like you said, the pioneer in a way of a new way of doing things. Get used to different.
Get used to different. Absolutely. That's a wonderful place to leave it. Thank you so much for chatting to us here at Premiere. It's been a pleasure.
You.